Hello everybody, this is the Praetorian again. I am on here tonight wanting to talk about something that crossed my mind as I was doing my last post. Sorry about my 10 p.m. Video not being in at 10 p.m. It was posted late because I was busy creating a really cool background for these videos. I was on YouTube Creator Studios, and then I went to my Movie Maker, and then from my Movie Maker I'd go to my Wondershare Pro converter. But I came up with a good background for these broadcasts. Later on I'm going to use my I'm going to use Wondershare to do a little bit more with these backgrounds, but I'm satisfied with it so far. If you guys want to check it out, feel free to check it out. I've also got really good playlists on there on my YouTube channel. I finally got it all organized 2 days ago, and I've got all different kinds of news media sources too on there that I've subscribed to. If you guys are into the whole liberal thing, I've got a bunch of liberal subscriptions. If you're conservative, I've got conservative subscriptions. If you're into what Sibel Edmonds likes to call the pseudo-alternative media, I've got The Real News Now, and I've got, or The Real News, and I've got Democracy Now! On there. And like I said, I've got tons of playlists from the new, or from New China, and different group media sources from other countries that are in English, so check it out. Well, with all that said, let me get on to what I was talking about. I was writing my 10 p.m. Or I was doing my 10 p.m. video, and the topic, it was about socialism in France, and it started bringing back old thoughts that I used to have when I was going through all that information, and I started remembering things that I forgot. Like, a lot of people aren't really aware of what's actually going on in France. A lot of people don't understand the whole concept behind this socialist movement. The topic of the broadcast was LeonBlum. He was the prime minister that first got socialism started in France during the early 1900s. And because of his reforms and his programs, he was completely blinded to the fact that there was a German-Rome axis going on that was leading up to World War II, and that actually caused his country to be taken by Germany within, I believe it was a week, because he wasn't prepared. Instead of worrying about his military, he was worrying about socialist issues like, you know, the 40-hour week and things like that. So whenever it came to defending his country, France just couldn't do it. They were busy doing everything else. They had a non-aggression thing going on too, where they didn't even get involved in the I think it was the Spanish Revolution back then. They stayed out of it. But check that out too. It'll make you really think, especially with the things that were going on back then compared to what's going on now. You'd see a lot of similarities. I really believe that with things that are happening over in Europe right now, if they don't wake up and get their heads out of their rear ends, a lot of bad things are going to happen. It's time for their governments to stop coming up with reforms that take away people's protection, you know. I've heard that London is actually trying to take away the right for their citizens to carry knives. They've already taken their gun rights. I don't even know if they've had gun rights, to be honest. I need to check that out. And I also was going through my information, and it dawned on me too, you know, France didn't even have the separation of church and state until socialist reforms started up, and then the Socialist Party over there. I completely forgot about that. But there's a lot of interesting things that I did find out. I really had a good time doing this one. Like I said in my blog, in my video, that I don't have a blog for this yet. I have been going through the materials, I've been working on it, but I haven't really pulled a blog together yet on it. So you guys are getting the first part of this before it hits any kind of wording. And it's just like with this, eventually you won't hear bad grammar coming out of my mouth, you know, and I'll be able to actually sound right. I'll have my voice up high enough to where it makes sense. And I'm wondering if it's the volume on here too, actually. Nope, the volume's up high. But I'll work on those issues. But when it comes to my blogs, don't worry about bad grammar and punctuation. I have old blogs that I've had on my my blogger and my WordPress, but I've turned those into drafts, and I'm going to go through those and work on them and bring them back out. But until then, they're not going to be posted. So everything that you see of mine that is actually published will have good grammar, and it will sound good. If it doesn't, correct me on it. I need the feedback. Don't think twice about telling me, you know, hey, look, this is how you're supposed to say this, or this is how this is spelled, or you have a comma in the wrong place, because I have no problem with that. I've been working on my grammar now for about two and a half months. I'm also in the process right now of going through some of my material that relates to DCFS. After the other day, it really helped me out, you know, getting on here talking about it. So I'm gonna put out some, you know, videos on that too, telling my story and what happened and everything concerning that, because I need to be as precise as I can. And like I said, I know some people on Google Plus who are into, you know, protecting people against the DCFS. So if anybody needs to find out what link that is, just ask me, and I would be more than willing to pass that along to you. Because I'm going to tell you right now, if you are a single parent, I don't care if you're the custodial parent or the non-custodial parent, you need help. You know, when you think about the DCFS, you always think about the bad parent down the street. Well, just remember, the same laws that are used for those bad parents are the same laws that apply to you too. It could happen to you. So it's best to be on your guard, know your rights, and have the tools that you need to take care of yourself if something happens. There's stories coming out now, even on the news, about mothers who let their kids go across the street to a park, and all of a sudden here comes DCFS knocking on the door. So don't be one of those parents. Be prepared. What else? Oh yeah, YouTube. You know, this thing about YouTube and their censorship, don't get me wrong about that either. You know, I'm not saying that they're 100% exonerated. I'm actually on the wall about that, you know, because, like, and because I don't agree with it. That's first off, I don't agree with it. But you know, I started putting my videos on monetary just for the kicks of it, because you know, for me, I want to know what's going on, and being on monetary or monetizing your videos, everybody's always talking about it. So I figured I'd do it, and I did it. And the thing about that whole thing is I hear this big ruffle, or this big controversy that's going on about it. And the things that I've been getting a lot of slack about when it comes to the monetization on my videos is three things. Two things. One, I understand it was, I wrote an article, or I did a video about the Democrats are actually the ones that created the KKK. And of course, you know, I said KKK in the headlines, and they said that it wasn't good enough for monetization. Well, I'll let that one go. But all the other ones went right by. Well, the thing about it is, though, is everything that I always get slack about, or other than that, is just boring stuff. I did a video just here recently, and it was about, you know, agrarian societies, you know, being introduced into industrialization and turned into an urban society. I mean, it's boring shit. I don't understand why YouTube said that it wasn't good enough for monetization. You know, this is material that is just, nobody wants to hear that stuff unless they're interested in it, and there aren't very many people out there that are really interested in UNICEF and, or UNESCO, I'm sorry, and urbanization of agrarian societies. You know, I mean, it just, it amazes me on stuff like that. I don't think they really know what they're doing, is what I'm trying to say. I believe that their monetization guidelines aren't really working out for them. And a lot of these websites, I believe, if they don't get their shit together and get off this political correctness, they're going to end up being the new, what was it? the new, oh my God, I forgot what it's not Facebook. I forgot the damn thing. MySpace. Wow. If they don't get their heads out of their asses and off this political correctness bullshit, they're gonna be the new MySpace. And that's just my opinion. It's the way I see it. But I mean, look at MySpace. You know, they thought they were on top of the world one moment, next thing you know, they're losing everything. So you think you're on top until you're on the bottom. I know all about that. So that's my take on the whole situation, and that's what's been going on in my few days. I've been trying to catch up. It's like 5 in the morning. I can hear the birds chirping right now, and the sun's getting ready to come up, and I'm sitting in the backyard doing this video or recording. So I'm gonna let you guys go, give you guys another day to be happy and try to do the right thing. You guys have a good day. Bye.